YouTube, what's going on? In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can beat the last mission in Act 3 and get this amazing skin, the Bone Collector, easy, even if you're solo. All right, so let's talk about what you want to take in with you. So you want to make sure that you have decoy grenades on, throwing knife, and the ether shroud. The decoy grenades distract the zombies, and they act like a monkey bomb. The throwing knife can one-shot any enemy if they're not plated, and if they are plated, it can two-shot them. The ether shroud is really good to have in case you get stuck in a pickle, because you can pop this and then you can heal up, reload, do what you gotta do without the zombies attacking you. Now that we've gone over the tacticals, let's go over what I was running for my weapon. So I took in the Holger 556, and this is the class setup I was using. The Shadow Strike Suppressor, the X10 Phantom Hand Stop, the MK3 Reflector, the 40 round mag, and the more 20 grip. So ideally you want to have a legendary weapon as well, but I only did this with an epic ether tool, so it is possible. But I pack a punched it to rank 3. So they're the two things you want to do with your weapon. You're also going to need Juggernog, Depth Perception, Speed Collar, and Stamina Up. Obviously Juggernog so you can take more damage, Speed Collar so you can reload quicker and plate up quicker, Stamina Up so you can run quicker, and Depth Perception is going to basically give you war hacks so you can see when the zombies are coming. I only took one weapon in because once you pack a punch the Holger 556, you get 120 rounds, which is plenty. And I didn't take a secondary in because you want to be able to switch to no weapon so you can run quicker. You also want to make sure that you have the Shadow Blast ammo mod equipped to your weapon, as this is going to help you out a lot as well. Some key notes to add before I start the gameplay. The Aether Worm at the end does three things you need to watch out for. He drops these purple orbs. As soon as they come at you, you need to kill them immediately. He also shoots a purple beam. If you can, you want to avoid this. It'll probably take 2 to 3 plates off you. And the third thing I've worked out how to avoid is he goes on the ground and creates an earthquake. If you watch the video, you'll see what I do and you can avoid this completely. All right, now all the nitty gritties out of the way, I'm going to start the gameplay. If you enjoy the video, please like and subscribe. I'm real close to 1,000 subs and I really appreciate it. Make sure you guys watch the end because you get a secret calling card for killing the Aether Worm solo. As always, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Enjoy the video.
push.
Sentry deployed.
Thank you.
Send him to the brig. Green will get the interrogation started. They say that Zakhaev, he may be bloodied, but he's still breathing. Next time he sticks his head up, I'll take it off.
What about the neutralizer?
Dobbs, what's the shit, Rip? Give me some good news.
Negative. Good initial clear on detonation, but dark ether contacts are repopulating.
Pipiet.
Also picking up an energy spike in the red zone. Never seen anything like it.
Well. Looks like this shit show just keeps getting better and better. Everyone on TP! Looks like this op isn't gonna be over anytime soon.
Bang. Travel off. Ready for evac.
Star copy. Stand by. ETA 2 minutes.